Tonight we are dining at Sear and Sea at JW Marriott Bonnet Creek. If you don't know, we do dining reviews every single Monday, so be sure to check those out. So before we were seated, we actually started out with some pre-dinner cocktails in the Sear and Sea Bar. So we are out here at the Sear and Sea Bar before we have our dinner, and we've gotten a couple cocktails out here. This is a gin fizz, and it is super awesome. You can't get this actually many places, but this is a gin bar. They have a huge gin wall over there, and that is why they are able to make this awesome cocktail. It has 2 ounces of gin in it, and it's actually a lemon gin. And then it gets this like foaminess almost at the top that when they pour the soda water in there, it just rises up and looks really cool. It's an awesome presentation. And taste-wise, it's very light. You definitely get like a lemon, like pie flavor almost in there. And if they would use more of a lime instead of the lemon, I think it would taste just like a key lime pie. But like I said, it's super light, even though it looks like it could be kind of heavy. It's a really great gin cocktail, and I normally don't even like gin.
So for my pre-dinner cocktail tonight, I have got a rum old fashioned. And not only is it just a rum old fashioned, but it is a amazingly well made and smoked old fashioned, which was fantastic. I mean, anytime I've got a smoked drink, it's always good. The difference here with this is that it's made with a plantation pineapple like infused rum, basically, and it is super smooth. And I almost want to get another one, but I feel like if I'm going to get something else, you know, for the sake of showing you more options, I should do that. Oh man, but it smells just wonderful. That is so good. Nice and smooth. And just a little bit of like a pineapple like flavor in it. All right. So with dinner tonight, we are doing the Orlando Magical Dining. We've explained this before, but what they do is they offer a 3-course meal for $35 per person, an appetizer, an entree, and a dessert. And there are usually several selections from each one that you can choose from so that it's a little bit more customized for your liking. Now, with that being said, they do have some upgrades and accompaniments tonight if you are able to make it here beforehand, before they stop, because it stops on the 31st of October. But we also got a side and an appetizer that is not on there as well. So we ordered this off the regular menu. We've got artisanal bread, which is coming. And then we also ordered the mac and cheese with pimento cheese, bacon, and jalapeno, which sounds bomb.com. So one thing that I didn't get to talk about yet is another drink that I got. And I got this because the Sear and Sea bar out there is a gin bar. And of course, the first drink that I got was not a gin drink. So I wanted to get something that was gin. This is the Rosemary Beret. It's Hendrick's Gin, Torch Rosemary, Raspberry Lemon, and Aquafaba. If you don't know what Aquafaba is, look it up, because it's a little weird. That smells amazing. This drink is very different. A little bit of bitterness in there, and a little bit of sweetness. It's a little strange, but I do like it. It's very smooth. It's obviously, you know, it looks good. I think the coolest thing is if they smoke or burn rosemary, which is a nice effect. But it's pretty good. I like it. So the first appetizer that we got was not on the Orlando Magical Dining. We did pick this off of the regular menu. It is $7, and this is the artisanal bread. So it comes with 4 rolls, 2 multigrain and 2 white rolls, I suppose you would say. And then we've got the breadsticks as well, which we haven't tried yet. But what is really great is the garlic butter that is served with these. So we have a rosemary and conchita garlic butter, and we have a black garlic butter. Two very, very different. The rosemary confit garlic butter is very much that more traditional, savory-ish. It doesn't have any salt in it, but you definitely pick up on those rosemary notes in there for the butter. But the black garlic butter is very different. This is much, much sweeter and a little bit different. And I actually don't like a sweet butter, but this is actually really good. I like it. It has this strange sweet garlic taste to it. Very good. So I really like this so far.
For my appetizer tonight, I got the lobster bisque. This comes with butter poached lobster, grapes, brioche, and caviar. This lobster bisque was so good. It had a nice rich flavor in there, but I also really liked that there were a few pieces of lobster and not just one little piece, because lobster bisque is more of just a creamy soup and not necessarily about the pieces of lobster that are in it. So I did like that there was a little extra on there. I thought the grapes were going to be a little odd because I've never had grapes in lobster bisque before. However, they had a nice like contrast of flavor with some sweetness in the soup. So I almost didn't try it, but I was like, you know what? If it's on here, I better just try it. And it actually went together really well. And then I liked the caviar on there. That was a nice touch. It gave a little extra saltiness in there. Overall, that was a really good lobster bisque. And presentation was beautiful. I've noticed that so far throughout the meal. Presentation of everything has been amazing. And with the lobster bisque, I love how they poured it into the bowl in front of you. That was awesome.
So for my appetizer, I got the baby artichoke. This is vinaigrette, lemon aioli, Iberico ham, and remoulade. I honestly was a little unsure about this. I've never had this as an appetizer, I guess, which is why I had some doubts. But the way that it is prepared is quite interesting. So you do get a nice, strong taste of the vinaigrette mixed with like a nice saltiness from the Iberico ham. But what's even crazier is that the artichoke itself looks like it's fried. And so you get this really nice crispy crunch on the outside, but then a really nice, soft, tender artichoke on the inside. And it is just phenomenal with that lemon aioli in there as well. It is actually pretty light for being something that could be almost a little heavy. I really, really like this. This is really good.
And so actually, compliments of the chef tonight, Chef Alex, we actually have the hand-cut steak tartare, which comes with grainy mustard, smoked tomato, and beef chicharrones on the side. And then we also have the smoked main scallop with pickled heirloom carrot, mint, and pea, and a lobster jus. These both look amazing. We're ready to start trying them. So we tried the scallops first, and they were cooked to perfection. They were super tender, not rubbery at all. They had a perfect sear on the top and the bottom. And then I actually really like the mint and pea puree that comes with them, and then the lobster jus. And also I don't really like carrots, but the pickled carrot on top with everything just kind of combined together, it's literally a perfect bite. It was so good. That lobster jus was probably my favorite component of the whole dish with the scallop.
So for the hand-cut steak tartare, understand that this is something that is very adventurous because it is raw beef or raw steak. So I'm giving that forewarning, but don't let that turn you away. You should definitely still take a bite and try it. I'm not a huge fan of beef tartare, but this was actually really, really nice. Tender, creamy. There's a little bit of a slight like heat to it. You have the grainy mustard in there. A little bit of that smoked tomato, I think, combined with that grainy mustard might add a little bit of heat to it. But overall, it's actually pretty good. And then if you add it with the chicharrones and you put it together,
for my meal, I got the 8-ounce filet mignon. It comes with Anson Mills polenta, charred broccolini, and a red wine demi. This steak was cooked to perfection. Whenever I cut it down through the middle, it was a nice medium, almost medium rare on the inside. It was perfect. And it has a nice char on the outside because they do finish it off on the wood-fired grill over there. And they use like a rosemary olive oil on the wood fire grill, and like the flames just shoot up, and it's awesome just to sit here and be able to watch them cook it all. Now, I actually do not like polenta, so I didn't even have any. But the broccolini was really nice as well. It was cooked perfectly. It's got a nice little crunch still to it, and it's seasoned nice, just some salt and pepper. This steak was fantastic. Now, like Josh mentioned at the beginning, we did also get a side of mac and cheese. It is made with a pimento cheese, some jalapeno, and bacon. The bacon helps give it a nice little smoky flavor, and I've actually never had mac and cheese made with pimento cheese before, and I think everywhere should use pimento cheese for their mac and cheese because it was amazing. It's nice and gooey, and the type of noodles that they use, the cheese like kind of gets inside of them and like oozes out whenever you take a bite. It is so good.
So for my entree tonight, I got the branzino. This is served with crispy quinoa, preserved lemon, cilantro, capers, and cauliflower. And cauliflower is more of a puree at the bottom, and overall, it was fantastic. What I really love about branzino and the way that it's prepared a lot of times, it has this amazing crispy outer crunch to it, like basically on the skin. But then the fish itself is still so tender, flaky, pull apart. It is, it's great. Really good. And I like that little bit of citrus mixed with the crispy quinoa in there as well. So it was good. It was a really great dish. I would definitely get it again. I always love branzino. It's great.
For dessert, I had the key lime creme brulee. This is pretty much a traditional creme brulee. However, it was served in a bowl instead of a typical, like, almost ramekin style dish. However, it was really good. You got a nice tartness from the key lime, and then the custard was nice and smooth. And my absolute favorite part of creme brulee is the caramelized sugar on top, and when you take your spoon and you have to crack it to get down inside to the nice gooey custard. It was perfect.
For my dessert tonight, I had the white chocolate cheesecake. This is served with braised berries, strawberry coulis, lemon ginger sorbet, and it was, oh my gosh. I was a little bit like apprehensive about it because I'm not like a huge white chocolate fan. But there wasn't as much of that white chocolate flavor to it as I thought that there was going to be. And that may just be because it was balanced out really well with the braised berries. And it was really good. Again, it was kind of like that perfect cheesecake. And then also served with the lemon ginger sorbet on the side. I don't know that it was necessarily needed, but what it did do was help to balance out, I think, a little bit of the heaviness of the cheesecake was balanced out by that sorbet. So I think this is an awesome dish. Again, I'm not a super huge sweets fan on the dessert side, but I will always go for a cheesecake, and I don't think anybody turns down sorbet. So, perfect combination for me. new favorite restaurant?
It's possible.
Maybe.
I don't know. It was fantastic.
It was really good. Yes, we are getting rained on right now. We're trying to like do it before we leave, and we're trying to do it without the mask on, but fantastic restaurant.
I said overall plating was like
absolutely
amazing, and then like the food did not disappoint at all. Like that plating was like, it really brought you into the dish. Yes. And then whenever you ate it, it was just like, oh my gosh, because everything was perfect.
Yes. And I think the other thing too, what I really like about this place is that it's not super big.
The restaurant's small.
It has a very like intimate feeling to it. Mm-hmm. And of course, having that open kitchen area right there and being able to see them kind of throw those steaks on the grill. Mm-hmm. And the fire like going and stuff like that. It's I really like it. And of course, mm-hmm. like the flavors are just amazing. So.
Yeah. Overall, a great new restaurant here in the Orlando area.
Yes.
We are so glad we got to finally come and try it. We've been checking it out for a while, but we just never made our way over. And we're glad we finally did.
Yeah.
So let us know if you plan on coming over to JW Marriott Bonnet Creek and trying out Sear and Seafood.